I could take this opportunity to ask you to float over in this direction. We have a few messages from the world of tight reality to bring to you, such as this program is about to end, and a major vibrational shift is about to occur. You should know about that. You've been listening to music from the hearts of space with Timotheo and Anna, and this last hour we featured three albums from Germany, Stefan Mikus, M-I-C-U-S, a record called Koan, K-O-A-N, from San Diego, William Aura, A-U-R-A, and a recently released cassette album called Timeless. We heard Timeless 1, that is the zither music with various other embellishments. And this exquisite music we've been hearing for the last 20 minutes or so from Hawaii, from the Global Pacific label. It's called Lemurian Sunrise. Lemurian Sunrise. And it's the work of Paul Warner, who plays piano on that album, and Steve Kindler, who's responsible for the very higher consciousness electric violin. We'll be back in 1 week with more music from the hearts of space. Remember, if you're going out now, take care, because this is the time of night that they turn the gravity up, and you never can tell what'll happen. So do be careful. If you're sticking around for Over the Edge, it's definitely happening tonight. I guess that's about it. We've enjoyed flying and floating with you. And we'll be back next week with more harmonic space music from now and then. Good night, spaceman, wherever you are. KPFA and KPFB in Berkeley, KSCF in Fresno. Thank you.
Fighting Eight. Field A for Fighting Eight. Start, start. Ladies and gentlemen, we have just come down below deck. This is October 12, 1944, and the air group here, our fast carrier task force, has just struck at Formosa. We are aboard a certain carrier which houses air group 8, and we are down in the ready room now, and as the boys put it, this is the day they have been waiting for, believe you me. And air group 8, ladies and gentlemen, is made up of fighters, torpedo bombers, hell diver, bombing planes. But Fighting 8 today really had a field day, and we'll start off the story. I don't want to ruin it. We'll start it off here by talking to the skipper and then to the other pilots who were in on this first strike at Formosa. The first strike at Formosa. They've just been back about 20 minutes. And here is the skipper of Fighting 8, Commander Bill Collins. Commander, what you went into?
Well, we ride over the target. There wasn't anything at the first field. Proceed to the second field of Taiyam. And,
tell you what, let's do. We got a map over here, so if the people at home, if they have their map handy, they can take a look at this map. Now, you had 38-2, which is our present group in the task force, had the northern, shall we say, one-third of the island.
That's correct.
And the real target was to have been over here, wasn't it? Shinchiku?
Yes, we went first to Shinchiku, and there were no cops taking off there. The bombers from another carrier, fighter bombers, dropped their bombs, did a very fine job of bombing the barracks, hangars, installation areas.
Will no one lay?
And then after that, we proceeded up to Bahia, which is up northeast of Shinchiku.
That's on the northern tip, the northwestern tip of Formosa. And that's where you ran into the field.
Well, we didn't run into them at the start.
I think
the other fighters from the other carrier spotted some planes taking off from IEM. They disposed of those promptly in about 2 minutes. I believe there were five or six knocked down in the next 2 minutes. Right after that, while we were covering them and climbing to regain our altitude, my number four man, Tom Lamoureux, invited us to take a look up at above us. In fact, he called through the cockpit at that point. I looked up, the sky was black and bleak. Japanese fighter, yes.
Well, let's go hold off. How many fighters did you have in the air, fighting 8 airborne our carrier?
We had 15 fighters.
And how many planes did you knock down?
We knocked down 31.
Airborne planes.
Airborne.
Not counting any on the ground.
That's correct.
31 in the air.
That's right.
No matter how many did you get?
I got 5.
That's the most of any of the group, is that right?
Anyone have? I know, yes.
How many does that bring your total up to?
That gives me 9.
9 planes right now. Oh, that's tremendous. And have you left anything for the next 3 sweeps this afternoon?
Yes, judging from the force of the other pilots, due to our being out of ammunition, we weren't able to take out after about a dozen more that sailed into the clouds. There should be some more pickings in there unless our yellow friends decide to stay on the ground.
Ready? And there are other targets that we cannot mention right now because that you're going over there, but Matsuyama is one target at an airfield in the northern tip, and Shinchiku might have something this afternoon, you don't know, and we have a couple of seaplane bases and a transformer station and some oil refiners and so forth later today, is that right?
That's right.
Well, good hunting, and my gosh, I hope he gets 31 more over there today. This is a happy group. The captain just called down and congratulated the boys, and they hollered up and said, you've got a pair of wings, come on along with us, and he said, that's a deal, I think I will. Well, let's go down the line here and find out some of the boys. Thank you very much, Commander Bill Collins. Let's go down the line and find out who the boys were. Hello, how are you?
Fighter.
Fighter, that's right. Fighter, how'd you do?
I got 2 and 1 bailed out on me.
Didn't even have to shoot at him. What's the plan?
I started to make a run on me when I pulled my nose up into it just before I fired. Bailed out. Another 2 planes that went in. They were on the tail of someone else. The best fight I've ever seen.
Just a minute, we get our cord unhooked down here. It's on the floor here. How far can we go, Red? All right, fine. Let's get down here. Were you on the run this morning? What's your name?
McCormick, W.A.
W.A. McCormick, where are you from?
Chicago, Illinois.
Good, good. How many did you get?
2. I got 1 nick and 1 sink.
1 nick and 1 sink. Well, what's the difference?
The nick, twin engine, single sail fighter, and the sink, single engine fighter.
You have any trouble games yet, chasing around?
No, I shot one of the Zeke off of Danny Reed's tail, my section manager, and I shot the pick down right over the field, broke away from the formation, Edwards was your honey.
Oh, yeah.
Anything, what else did you see over the time?
Well, Vanderlyn and I chased one all over creation. He gave it the run for about 5 minutes right down in the water. And finally, I straightened out and let him get out of my tail. Van tucked around and burned him. He went in right in the drink.
Went right in the drink. Yeah. They came up and,
oh, that's a tremendous record for day 30.
We first arrived over the field, and there appeared to be nothing at all. And I was getting in position to take a photographic run, and I happened to turn back, and I saw some of the planes kicking up a lot of vapor trails there. So I picked out one and got him right off the start. Started out right. Then I smoked another, and I hit him and started smoking. Didn't burst the flame bomb, either a smoker or a burner.
Yeah.
Burners are certain. And then I kicked around a couple of times, and I saw one heading down, smoking. And so I trailed him down. He leveled off, going across the field, down about 500 feet. So I shot him down and burned him.
Big one, two of them, three of them. Well, our battery. He was low, boy. I'm not kidding you. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. He came right down, looked like he was coming right down on the deck. I couldn't see anybody seeing him at all. I just thought they all heard it. Down there too.
Tonight? Welcome to the Wax Santa Claus Revenge. This is your host.
Well, I don't go around here.
We do. Please, let us in. Knock, knock, knock. Let us knock. Let us in. Knock, knock. We've been waiting all so long, Mummy.
Let us in. Oh, squawks, you get me?
been waiting for a long time for this.
What?
Let's make it more than wooden. Let's make it grainier than wooden. Let's make it absolutely metal.
Is anyone there? Is anyone there? Big ideas? We're taking big ideas tonight.
Yes, hello, you're on the air.
Big ideas here.
So, well, let's have them jump even taller so that we can't even grab on without picking them out. Sorry, we're not quite even understanding. One more time, we can't use you unless you give us something better to grab boxing. One more time. Monica, please.
I don't even know how to.
One of the fairest among Lady Slang. What? We are your favorite. No, you are not our favorite. We are your favorite. Not only can we hum tunes that you have never heard of, but we hum tunes that, oh, the thing is so long. Our chords stretch.
Big ideas.
I'd be alone as I
big
can
ideas.
Get.
We do those big
if
ideas.
I were president. You know my big idea?
Go ahead. We'd
Jack
like to
National
hear
National Geographic, I'd say about 1945. And if you think, put your mind in 1945, okay? There's any National Geographic. They have no pictures on the cover, just words. Murder. Same old yellow cover as National Geographic had year after year after year. Exactly. Now, say... National Geographic magazine just hired you.
Hey, what's
the color
big
photograph
idea?
On the cover.
Hey, what's the big idea?
1945? Incredible.
Hey,
if you put it
what's the big idea?
Photograph on the cover. I'm afraid that was the days of Life magazine for that sort of thing.
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
So that was a great magazine in those
yeah,
days.
Yeah, you. Great
question.
Magazine. What's the big idea?
Question.
Hey, I want to know right now.
What? Photograph?
What is it? What?
Photograph of what?
Is it, sir?
You had your choice of putting...
What?
On the cover of National Geographic back in 1945, when they had absolutely no photographs on the cover at all, with a black and white color. Which
hey,
country and what kind
idea?
Of people would it be?
Well, of course, Japan. What else?
What
yeah,
person
I'm
or an animal
what's
would it
the big
be?
Idea?
An animal?
Yeah,
what person?
I want an animal.
What kind of animal would it be?
Joseph Stalin.
Go ahead, sir. What's the big idea?
What's the big idea? Joseph Stalin is no animal. We would like to... kind of animal would it be? Insert animal here.
Do what thou wilt shall be the whole. Of the law.
Oh, yeah?
Love is the law. Love under will.
Oh, yeah? Yeah! big idea anyway?
Leave the load, honey child.
What you heard me.
I believe that last comment was Jesus God.
Jesus what? I didn't know that was his last name. Every time I write him a letter, no wonder he never returns my mail. He doesn't.
Yeah,
I didn't know that was his last name.
How are you today?
Yeah. What is Harriet's last name?
Harriet, are you out there?
You can't always get what you want.
Harriet, are you out there?
I am not out there, honey child.
Are you, Harriet?
I'm never there, but I'm always here.
Harriet.
You can come in a month?
Maybe less. Maybe one rotation of the cube.
Alright, I'll call you.
And, you have my number still.
Don't forget the headsets.
And, do you have Rob's number?
Yeah.
Well, he's got those.
Hmm.
I think I told him that also.
We missed you.
These nuclear devices.
We missed.
You heard about the Argentinian?
We missed.
Hey, hello?
Every one of them.
We miss your tapes.
No, not the people dead. Just the ones that have escaped from Germany.